this topic about chroma keying, and these shots are from the commercial made by me. It was all taken on chroma key in green screen. You see, looks very natural and very realistic, and I tried to preserve all details in hair, in the skin, and preserve the shadows and highlights, make smooth edges as it would be in photography. And in source media you see the same details, and we need to maximal preserve them. In this work, very important to get atmosphere and light according to our scenario. For example, in this one I got great foggy wipe, and of course you see the nice movement of our camera. Now I want to show you this example and use this shot to create the new scene. In this one you see our hair details is preserved. We have lighter and darker areas, and for this demonstration I prepared another background, more lighter. This is the schematic of my construction. This is a 8K helium footage. I resize it and change the color from Loxy to HD using color management node. And this is the setup that you haven't seen before. The concept is the color extraction. You see this gray card. I blend my source and gray and change the option to color. Separate only color. You see no luma information. And use the mono node to extract the green channel and give this low contrast mate. After that I add the contrast. You see my color correction node, and you need to play to get the maximum precise contrast, and our raw mate is ready. Now time to show how you can create clean plate. This is my clean plate setup. You see our source media, and what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna add another color correction node and get extremely contrasted image. You see black and white is clipped. Don't worry about these details. I invert this mate and use the pixel spread to interpolate this image. And this technique is useful image-based keying. Okay, second node is blur node. This is small controller for edges. And you see the second gear. This is the same construction from previous gear. And this one is key, the clean plate, because we need to combine these two mates, our raw mate and clean plate mate, and I divide these two mates, and very important to clamp this output. Another blur node. You can control the smoothness of edges. Okay. Now you see the color source node. This is the same green picked from background of our source. Okay, you see the same green. And I subtract this green plate to our clean plate. And when you see the output, this is actually our clean plate. I multiply these two outputs. And finally, I add to source media and get the cleanest background ever. You see, when I compare these two green screens, you see the huge difference between these two outputs. Very nice result. I changed a little bit the exposure, and you see all details preserved. We have little difference because our background color is changed, and the result is incredible. We have marker points and clean plate, everything is clean. For example, I add a color correction node and do this source more contrasty. And you see this uneven light. And when I compare to our clean image, we have absolutely even background. Okay. Now we have the clean green screen, and time to start key this image. I use same technique, same keyer combination, and add master keyer to spill image. You see the result and spill image. Now we get more accurate mate. You see the output. We have some noise in background. And of course, don't worry about that. It's easy to fix. Use the Neat Video noise reduction for that. You see, I bypass it. And when I turn on, it works great. And very important to use denoiser only to mate output and not for the source node. Okay, I add the color correction and get a little bit brighter our image because our background is brighter. You see the source background. And I add the blur node to make some defocus. Of course, many artists do this technique for additive keying, and I assure you that will give you the same result. I combine the spilled source media and the background and use this raw mate, and of course pre-multiply the input. See the difference? I can get the same as I get with additive keying. After all this, I add the pixel spread. And finally, I get the pixel accurate image. This is a very nice result. For comparing source and output, I add I copy this color correction node and connect to my source media. And you see, when I toggle between two images, you see the hair details are maximum preserved. You see this semi-transparent hairs. And I turn on my denoiser, and you see a fantastic result. It's a very clean background. Now I will show you the difference between this technique and traditional master keyer result. I add the master keyer. I use my background. And my corrected output. Okay, and start to compare. And when I start to toggle between these two outputs, you see the huge difference. And of course, the image-based keying is best technique for chroma keying. Okay, guys.